Hey guys, I'm coming back at it again with another video. Today's gonna be about unwatchable YouTubers. This isn't like an original idea, but you know, everybody and their mom has done this video, so I thought, you know what? Hop on the bandwagon and let's do my own. But yeah, it's like not original. I am running out of ideas. But you know, that's just like the creative flow. You just gotta take the opportunities you got, go with the flow, something like that. I don't know. Without further ado, make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and let's get on with the video. Just a little disclaimer, please don't get triggered. I really mean no harm. These people are doing their own things. I'm just sharing my irrelevant opinion.
I'm sorry if I say the word coin too much. I watched a Petty Page video before recording.
Okay, so the first YouTuber that I deem personally unwatchable is Superwoman, or II Superwoman, II, also known as Lily Singh. I don't know. I know that she does a lot of good stuff for like charities and stuff. And like, I found like one video entertaining, the Barbie Dreams parody. But aside from that, everything else, it's like, I don't know, it feels like forced comedy, like Vine comedy. It's just like, it doesn't appeal to me. It's very cut dry, kind of bland for my taste. And also, she just comes off to me very cocky, and that just might be like confidence, but I don't know, I just don't really like watching someone like that. Yeah. Okay, so next up on the list is Ian Jeffrey. That's his channel name, and he's pretty much known as James Charles' little brother. His content is very bland to me, in my opinion. But I don't know, it's just like, he's like dead inside and was like, can relate, but it's just to a point where it's just so bland. It's like I've had saltine crackers with more flavor. But yeah, I was like, get your coin. I'm not hating, you know, like mooch off of James Charles views. It was like, you do you, shishtar. But yeah, I don't know. I just don't find him entertaining. And I think the only reason that he's famous is because of his connection with James Charles. Honestly, some people on YouTube only get their name just because of their associations with other people. But hey, you can pay the bills. Okay, this one's pretty obvious, but it's Jake Paul. I think out of the two Paul brothers, I feel like he is less entertaining and from an unwatchable point. I don't know. All his content appeals to younger demographic. I don't really dig it. I've never really have. I did watch the Shane Dawson series. I was honestly just there for Shane and Alyssa, to be honest. I wasn't really interested about Jake Paul's life. And if I like look at his channel, it's like the Jake Paul Uncut. I think that's like supposed to like appeal to maybe like the 1% that actually felt bad for his made up stories on Shane's series. I don't know. I just feel like it's a ploy to just draw in some people, like show, oh, who's Jake Paul? Ooh, so interesting, so mysterious. But honestly, I don't think it's gonna be that great. But yeah, it was like, he's just unwatchable. I'm like, if you're an 11-year-old Jake Paul fan, please don't come for me. Okay, so the next YouTuber is Bobby Burns. I think everybody knows him from Shane Dawson. I think that was really what made him relevant for some time. But honestly, I think he's become irrelevant. And I think after the whole Shane Dawson thing, I think it's like a roller coaster. It just like crashed down. And I don't know, I just recently tried to watch a video. It was, I wrote a song with Shane Dawson's daughter. Honestly, it wasn't anything great. I think I yawned a few times. I'm sorry. But there was like this sponsor, and it was about like a Spanish thing and like how you Skype. But honestly, that spawn, it was just like so weird. He didn't even like say hola. He didn't say one word in Spanish and like, oh, you should do this, Spanish lessons. I was like, I don't think anybody's gonna do that. Like, I'm like, I'm taking this to a business side. But honestly, like, who's gonna trust someone who says, oh yeah, they accept people from all levels Blah, 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 blah. It doesn't even say a word in Spanish. I'm sorry. And of course, like, he uses Shane Dawson's daughter in the title. It was like, get your coin, get your views, whatever. You do you. But I'm not here for it. Sorry, but you're unwatchable, and that's the tea. Okay, last but not least on the list is Lele Pons. I have a confession to make. I used to be a Lele Pons fan. I really used to like her back in her Vine days. I even followed her on Instagram for a little while. I'm so embarrassed because of this. But in her Vine days, it just felt so more pure and actually like a little bit funny. But now her videos on her channel are just like so overproduced, and like the jokes, they're just, I don't know. It's just like pushed humor, pushed comedy, and I just don't really find it that funny. I was like also like considering not putting her on this list, but then I watched like the Google Home video, some quinceañera thing, and I haven't cringed that hard in a good month or so. So yeah, I will say Siloso is a bop. You can unsubscribe if you hate me for saying that. I'm sorry.
Want to hear a joke?
Okay.
Okay, what did the pickle say to the...
And there you guys have it. That is my video about unwatchable YouTubers, but don't get triggered at me because this is just my irrelevant opinion. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, and also subscribe if you're not already subscribed. Even leave a comment. It's getting real lonely in the comment section these days. And without further ado, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.